Conjoined twins Abigail and Micaela are finally home from UC Davis Children's Hospital, where they were born. While their family gets to know the baby girls,
and we'll have to replace skin on both.
For the surgical team that will separate them, it's time for complex planning.
The anatomy is fortuitous enough to be able to attempt a separation and hopefully come out with two healthy babies.
Abigail and Micaela are attached at the head, a condition called craniopagus, making them the rarest kind of conjoined twins.
It increases the level of sophistication necessary and planning necessary probably tenfold.
Separating their unique anatomy will require a truly custom approach.
No two of these twins born are the same.
Because the twins don't fit in regular baby car seats, and because of the COVID-19 pandemic, pediatric neurosurgeon Michael Edwards and plastic surgeon Granger Wong make house calls.
It's just like the old days, instead of the babies coming into the office, we go to them.
Look how she's tracking you. She's like, whoa.
The surgical team spends the next few months carefully tracking the twins' growth through MRIs and CT scans. The twins share some bone, brain, soft tissue, veins, and blood vessels. Thanks to 3D models of their skulls, the surgeons know the exact amount of new skin that will be needed to cover the spot on their heads where they'll be separated. As Dr. Wong explains, that new skin will be grown right where it's needed.
The first thing that we're going to have to do is something called tissue expansion, and that's where we place sort of a deflated balloon underneath the scalp skin. And then very slowly we inflate that with saline or salt water, and that blows up like a balloon, and with that it stretches the scalp.
The tissue expander is custom designed. In June, a surgery to insert it is a success, ensuring there will be enough skin to cover the exposed areas. Pediatric anesthesiologist Raj Damrate and nursing lead Aida Benitez will direct the team before and during the surgery.
There's not a lot of roadmaps. There's not a lot of nursing articles that have, you know, the recipe card on how to coordinate a case for something of this magnitude, something that's this rare.
Benitez is the family's main contact. For her and everyone on the team, the procedure now feels personal.
We'd all developed a bond with the girls and the family.
The nurses don't just like these babies. The nurses love these babies. They care for these babies.
The twins' mother, Lilia, posts frequent heartfelt updates on social media.
I'm so grateful to medical staff who take care of my girls. I'm thankful for the doctors that are involved and all the team.
The surgeons don't want to wait too long to separate the twins. As the girls get older, there are more risks of shared blood vessels and other complications. They decide they'll operate when the twins are 9 months old.
We're gonna wait on October 24. That's gonna be our big day, and that's the day when the girls will be separated. It's hard, but we will get there.